Hello everybody and welcome back to Easy Medicine. My name is Carsten, I'm a fourth year medical student and I'm super excited for this video as my technical abilities are now back or forth, better said, in the 21st century. I can now do a reaction video and I want to go for one of my favorite TV shows first. Scrubs, the beginners. I'm really looking forward to this. I hope you guys enjoy watching. If you do, consider subscribing if you're new to the channel and leave a like down below if you enjoyed the video and want to support me and the channel. Thank you very much and let's get straight into it.
Since I was a kid, I've been able to sleep through anything. Storms, sirens, you name it.
Not today.
Last night I didn't sleep. I guess I get a little goofy when I'm nervous. You see, today isn't just any other day. It's my first day. I'm the man. How sometimes life can be so unpredictable. And if they had to do it all again. And 4 years of pre-med, 4 years of med school, and tons of unpaid loans have made me realize one thing.
Good. Could you go drop an NG tube on the patient in 234 and call the attending if the lavage is positive?
I don't know, Jack.
This is so true. When you first arrive in the hospital and you just know theoretical stuff, you have no idea about practical skills or about all these abbreviations that are totally normal in the hospital but are never really mentioned in textbooks. So you're totally overwhelmed by the situation. But, and this is very important, the good thing is this goes away with time and you don't need a lot of time, it's just a few weeks. You will get into the rhythm, you will learn very fast and very quickly, no worries, and you will adapt to this new situation. So everything's going upwards and uphills from that point on. But everyone is shocked in the first moment when they have the first day in the hospital. That's hard.
I wanted to help people, but orientation yesterday? It didn't really focus on patient care.
The hospital doesn't want to be sued. Being sued is not a good thing.
Hey, Turk.
Not so much about the lawsuits, but when you get into really practice, you suddenly realize that there are a lot of paperworks related to things that you don't know and you have no idea about. The insurance companies have specific regularities about how long patients can stay in the hospital and be treated for specific diseases they have. And this is something you were never told in med school, but suddenly you're in clinic and you have to practice medicine. You realize that there are a lot of paperwork that are completely unrelated to medical knowledge. You have to get into this. In Europe, we have not the problem with lawsuits like in America. But there is a lot of paperwork you are really unprepared for when you get to the hospital.
Hey, that was paged.
Aw, first day, Bambi.
Yeah.
Carla will take care of you. Don't look at me when we're moving somewhere.
Why?
Oh, wait.
You need friends in hospital and you need to get along with all your co-workers very well. They're super kind people. I've met only awesome people in hospitals, but you have to get along with them good and you have to be friends with them because you are spending a lot of time with those people and it's super important that you get along with them very well. This is super important and it doesn't matter if it's the doctor, a nurse, it doesn't matter any kind of co-worker.
We're waiting for Dr. Cutts.
Hi, doctor. I'm
place an IV for me.
We'll talk later.
Carla, can I ask you a personal question?
Do you spray the perfume on, or do you just fill your bathtub up with it at home and splash around in it?
I smell nice.
Come on, you've done this to cadavers before, so this guy's alive. Just poke it through his skin. Poke it through! Now!
Time's up. Carla, would you do it for him, please? I'm also gonna...
This is kind of true. You don't know the practical skills when you're in hospital, and you have to get over... There's a kind of a barrier to actually puncture patients or do any kind of procedures and you have to lose the fear of this. But you will get through this, very sure. Every student gets through this, every student has those fears, but if you have an experienced coworker with you, he will lead you, he will tell you exactly what to do, and if you follow this, you can surely do this after a few times and then you will get the courage to do it alone. Experience is here absolutely key.
Dr. Dorian, can you tell me what ailment most often...
I think I'm gonna love rounds. It's like being on a game show.
What is uremia?
That's my boy. And hey, nice clean job.
Clinical rounds and doing your rounds with your superior doctor is actually like a game show. Also in med school it's like a game show because you always have to think about new cases very quickly. You have to gather all your knowledge, apply all that knowledge to this situation, and so you can answer those questions. This is a really, really effective way of learning because they are suddenly asking a question that might be not related to your topic today, but something you spoke about the last year in med school in a different specialty. But you have to combine all that knowledge to solve cases and to get patients diagnosed. Really awesome and a great way of studying and learning.
Okay, Bambi, here's Mrs. Lenzer's tuck screen.
I wonder if Turk's having the same experience I am.
I'm such a stud.
Probably not.
This morning, I had my hands inside of a guy's chest. I couldn't even see them. I should not be allowed to do stuff like that.
What's that? And you weren't scared?
One way or another, everyone stops bleeding. It is so deep.
No, it isn't.
It's not kind of deep, but kind of true. when you first in the operating theater and you see first an operation, it's really, really astonishing because you see all those structures you have seen only on cadavers or in books in real life, and you apply the knowledge and understand suddenly the human body from a whole different perspective. It's kind of awesome. Really, really, it is awesome. No, it's just awesome.
I think this needle's too big. I'm gonna get a nurse.
Come on, man. Learn by doing. Learn by doing.
Why couldn't I do that? I hated him at that moment.
Okay, maybe the needle was just a little too big.
Oh, you think?
What's going on down there?
Nothing, man. This is totally normal.
This is exactly the reason why a superior and more experienced doctor should show you procedures first before you do it yourselves.
So, what's it like being a young hotshot doctor?
It's like, did you ever go see a movie that everyone told you was great, and then because of all those expectations, you ended up totally disappointed?
Movies nowadays have too many special effects.
This is absolutely true. I'm pretty sure there are a lot of med students out there who's thought of just get through the idea to study medicine because of all those TV shows that there are out there. They display medicine in kind of a twisted light, and I've never seen anybody sing a song on Ward or so. So don't get twisted by that. Do your practicals, try to get an insight before you start to study medicine, otherwise you will be disappointed for sure.
Code. See, here's how it works. Someone's heart fails, they beep everyone. The first doctor in has to run the room, tell everyone what to do, basically decide if the patient lives or dies. What, am I crazy?
You chicken.
Don't worry about the patient. Turk was already there, learning by doing.
Charge, clear!
No, no.
Plus, it turns out the guy was just sleeping, attached to a faulty monitor.
I thought...
Wait a second, champ. You got a urine sample in there for me?
I just did 5 minutes ago.
I know you did, but here's the thing. I'd like you to take this cup, put it on the ground, close your eyes, and just go nuts. What do you say?
Boy, go get him, champ.
This is absolutely awesome. You have to treat every patient individually, as nobody is the same, nobody understands the same things, and of course children are a whole different than adult patients. And if you get your child patient to do this by this, it's awesome. That's totally okay. Of course you have to clean it afterwards and don't leave it for the cleaning lady.
Why are you here?
Seems like a good kid.
You're worried about being on call tonight, aren't you?
Yeah.
Look, worst case scenario, you kill somebody, and that hangs over your head the rest of your life. But that is the absolute worst case scenario. Come on, Nui, look, just have the nurses do all the stuff you're still too chicken to do, which I assume covers just about everything. And if you have a really rough admission...
Call you?
No, I was going to say go hide in the closet again.
This is something I cannot imagine because I'm not in that stage, but having your first night shift, being more or less alone, not the usual friends around you, not the usual amount of workers around you. This is something I'm also still afraid of. Not afraid of is possibly not the right word, but I have a lot of respect for it, and I have to tackle it the right way when it comes that day. This is actually how busy it sometimes gets in the emergency department, and you still have to get through it, but you have good co-workers mostly with you, so you can get through this.
Hey, yeah, I lied before, man. I'm scared every second.
Really?
It's a good thing they make surgical masks, because if they didn't, everyone would know that my face is like this the whole time.
This is actually kind of true, because they throw you into hot water a lot of times, and you have to play it cool, because they expect you to. But it's great that you got a coworker, or you got a friend who can share your fear about and tell them that you got a problem with it, but you can go through it, get through it together, and you can talk to your superior doctors and tell them that you have not understand the procedure completely, and they will surely try to explain it to you.
And who's the good guy?
Car accident, crashed in the elevator on the way up.
We gotta relieve the pressure in his chest. JD, do it.
Oh God, no.
Look at me. You can do this.
And I believed him.
Chest tube tray.
You know, kinda.
Come on, baby, let's go. Chop, chop.
You can do this. You have to do this.
JD, cut him or lose him.
Okay, give me the tube. I can't get it through the flora.
Well, don't be gentle. Get it in there.
Okay, connect it, please, Carla.
Normal rhythm.
No way.
Hey, it's a piece of cake. It's your patient.
That's exactly what I was just talking about. If you got an experienced coworker and he can lead you, he can show you this was a little bit extreme. This would not happen in a real hospital if you haven't done anything before. But this is exactly, they believe in you and you can do it. Believe in yourself as they believe in you.
You see, I can't survive on my own.
I'm a dork.
Even now, when I finally get to go home, in the back of my head, I know the hospital's still here, wide awake.
Get out while you still can.
But what the hell?
This is so true. If you're on rotations and you're every day in the hospital, you still know the patients, you still know the routine for the next day, what's going to happen, which operations are planned, and you just get the update what happened during the night if you're lucky enough to get home. The hospital is always there, and this is kind of bad and kind of good.
The most important thing is that I got through my first 3 days without looking like a complete idiot. I'm the man.
Yeah, that scrubs the first episode. I love this show, I'm not gonna lie. I hope you guys enjoyed watching, and if you want more reaction videos, tell me down below with which episodes, or if you want another show. I haven't watched any other shows besides Dr. House, so if you want any other show, tell me down in the comments below, and I will give it a go and have a look at it. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Bye bye.